This is Optimal Health Daily, episode 949. Mechanical Advantage Drop Sets, The Smart Way to Build Muscle Fast, by John Romaniello of RomanFitnessSystems.com. And I'm Dr. Neil Malik, reading you some of the most popular health and fitness blogs out there, with permission from the websites, of course. Oh man, I am a big fan of drop sets, so I can't wait to read this to you. But really quickly, before I get to it, if you want to see pictures of us hosts of the Optimal shows, plus get some quotes and see some behind-the-scenes stuff and lots more, come follow us on Instagram. You can find us at Old Podcast. We would, of course, love to see you there. But for now, I'm excited to read to you this post, so let's get right to it as we optimize your life. Mechanical Advantage Drop Sets, The Smart Way to Build Muscle Fast, by John Romaniello of RomanFitnessSystems.com. When you're training to build muscle, you learn quickly that everything works, but that nothing works forever. The basic 3x10 approach from your high school football days probably hasn't been effective since, well, when you played high school football. As you progress, you learn that every aspect of a given workout is but a single piece of the strength training puzzle, and that each of those pieces can be modified individually to achieve a different effect and greater results. Whether it's increasing the weight, adjusting volume, or switching exercises, you'll undoubtedly begin to see what works for you. But as you advance in your training, this gets harder and harder, so it becomes important that you include more advanced training techniques so you can keep progressing. One of those advanced techniques is called drop sets. A drop set is when you perform a set of a given exercise to the point of fatigue or failure, and then change a variable in a way that allows you to continue performing the set. Keep in mind, everything can be treated as a variable in this equation. In traditional drop sets, the variable is the weight itself. You reduce or drop the weight once you reach fatigue, allowing yourself to perform a few more reps with a lighter load. These are also known as strip sets because you're stripping the weight off the bar. All told, this is a decent technique and yields results, but it can be made better in so many ways. But first, you need to look at the way that the weight affects the muscle. Without falling too far down the rabbit hole of muscle research, it's enough to say that in most cases, more weight means more muscle recruited, and that means more muscle built. Therefore, while drop sets are great, they suffer from the inherent issue of forcing you to use lighter weight as you progress deeper. With each subsequent drop, you're decreasing load. While you're still doing more work and getting closer to failure than traditional sets allow, you're not making the best of the heavy weight. In order to eliminate that deficiency, the goal would obviously be to keep using heavy weight. But how can you manage that if you're fatiguing further and further with each rep? What are mechanical advantage drop sets? When we talk about mechanics and training, we're really discussing positional adjustments as they apply to increasing or decreasing the leverage you're using to lift the weight, and therefore, the ease or difficulty with which you can perform the exercise. This leads us to mechanical advantage drop sets, or MADS, a type of drop set in which the variable is not the weight, but the exercises you perform with that weight. As an example, you probably noticed that it's easier for you to perform a bench press with a lower incline and harder to perform it with a higher incline. As you increase the incline, muscular leverage changes unfavorably, as does recruitment of individual muscles. More specifically, as you increase the angle and the incline gets higher, you place less emphasis on the chest and more on the smaller, weaker muscles of the shoulders. Put in terms more relevant to this article, the higher incline is mechanically harder. To set this up into a mechanical advantage drop set, you would start the chest press at a high incline, work to failure or fatigue, then drop the incline a bit. That is, with each successive set, you lower the incline and continue to work. You'll wind up being able to perform several more reps despite being fatigued. This is because you're stronger in that position of the lower incline than you were in the previous ones, the higher inclines. Of course, this can be done with any body part and with nearly any exercise. Let's flip it and let's look at back training. You can start, for example, with a wide grip pull-up. With your hands pronated and your arms splayed out, this is the weakest mechanical position based on which muscles will be at work in the exercise, as well as how the leverage of your arms will come into play. But by changing your hand and arm position from the weakest to ones that are more mechanically advantageous, you can perform more reps with each successive change, even though it's obvious that you've gone to failure on the previous set. Now, despite the fact that you're going to be fatiguing throughout the entire ordeal, by moving from weaker to stronger positions, you can complete an impressive number of reps, allowing for increased time under tension without a decrease in weight. You could apply this another way, using a bent over row. Start with a wide grip overhand row, then move to a narrow grip, and finally finish with an underhand row. So mechanical advantage drop sets are better than traditional drop sets because the load doesn't change. As I mentioned previously, with traditional drop sets, you're keeping your position static and decreasing the weight to perform more reps. But with MADS, the weight stays the same the entire time. The entire set is done with heavy weight. Now, as any bodybuilder will tell you, there is certainly some merit in training with lighter weights, at least in the sense that doing so allows you to train with high volume and frequency without impeding recovery too much. But speaking generally, most people are going to get a lot more out of consistently using more challenging weights. Not only will you get stronger, but lifting heavy weights also has more applicability to relative strength and to sports. Finally, with mechanical advantage drop sets, your weight is consistently heavy, and you get to push to fatigue and beyond, forcing more and more muscle fibers to be recruited with each rep and each mechanical change. It's an advanced method and certainly isn't easy, but if you're looking for a way to challenge yourself and force your body to grow, I think you've just found it. You just listened to the post titled Mechanical Advantage Drop Sets, The Smart Way to Build Muscle Fast by John Romaniello of RomanFitnessSystems.com. Dr. Neil here for my commentary. Now, I've talked about so-called drop sets before on this show, many times before. Sometimes I would call them pyramids. You may also have heard them called ladders. But what John has just added to the equation is genius. He's right in that lifting with heavy weights is one of the best ways to build muscle fast. And so I love the idea of instead of dropping the weight, which I talked about before when doing pyramids or ladders, instead here you keep the same heavy weight, you just maybe change the angle or change your hand position. You start with a more difficult position, and with the same weight, you make it a little easier on yourself with each set. And to me, that sounds super smart. And as John mentioned, you want to be sure that you're kind of an advanced lifter in the sense that you've been lifting weights for a little while, maybe you've received some personal training before you attempt this. This would not be a great technique for beginners. And if you can, it's probably a good idea to have someone spot you. Because again, you're going to be lifting heavy weights. You may not know how your muscles are going to respond to doing that kind of load. So you don't want the weights to fall on you. But again, if you're at that level and it's safe for you to do so, I'm a huge fan of these mechanical advantage drop sets. All right, that'll do it from me for today. I'll be back here tomorrow for a usual Friday Q&A, so stay tuned for that, where your optimal life awaits.
Hello, Life Optimizer. This is Justin Mollick, creator and producer of this show, and Optimal Living Daily, the brother podcast of this one. Literally, I'm Dr. Neil's brother. If you like the format of this show, you'll love Optimal Living Daily too, where I also read to you from blogs, but cover other topics like personal development, finance, and minimalism from bloggers like Derek Sivers, The Minimalists, Zen Habits, and many more. So for more amazing content read to you for free, come subscribe to Optimal Living Daily too, and together we'll optimize your life.
You've been listening to Optimal Health Daily. Be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on each new episode, and head to oldpodcast.com. That's OLDpodcast.com for a free gift, as well as more actionable tips and resources to help you maximize your potential. Thanks for joining us, and remember, your optimal life awaits.